In this video, I want us to consider the series, which actually has a variable inside of it. Let's find the sum of the series. The series is this infinite sum here, where n ranges from 0 to infinity of x to the n. So some things to point out here is that, first of all, oftentimes our series will start at n equals 1, but in this situation, we want it to start at 0. There's plenty of reasons why we might want to include 0. It's sort of just a starting point. We have to specify it. So that's, you see that at the bottom of the series there. But then what's also different about this one compared to previous examples is that there'll be a variable inside of it. We're taking x to the n. What does this add up to be? Well, because this is a geometric series where your constant ratio here is going to be x, and your initial term a is going to equal x to the 0, which will equal 1, this is a geometric series right here, and therefore we can use the formula for a geometric series. We're going to see here that the sum as n equals 0 to infinity of x to the n, this will equal the first term, which like we saw was x to the 0. And then we see on the bottom 1 minus the constant ratio, which is x right here. We get 1 minus x in the bottom. This simplifies to be 1 over 1 minus x. And so what we see right here is that this geometric series, because of the variable present, this is often referred to as a power series. This geometric series is actually equal to the expression, the formula of 1 minus x here, where this is a formula for x, right? And so what we can see, as long as the absolute value of x is strictly less than 1, it turns out that this function, 1 over 1 minus x, is actually equal to this power series. And it turns out that this connection is going to be quite, what's really important as we go further into this chapter. In fact, this type of connection, connecting a function to a series, is really the main reason why we are going to be studying series. Because as we've talked about, sequences are examples of discrete functions. A discrete function, that's what we mean by a sequence, compared to continuous functions we saw in the past. A series is actually an example of what we might call a discrete integral. This will become much more clear in the future here, but series, that is the sequence of partial sums, the limit of the sequence of partial sums, can be viewed of as like an integral, because after all, integrals, as we first learned about them in the continuous setting, these are limits of Riemann sums, where the Riemann sum in some respect is a sum of the original function. Well, that's what a series is. A series is also an infinite sum, where we add together the terms of the sequence. Now, in a Riemann sum, we want our rectangles to get thinner and thinner and thinner so that delta x gets smaller and smaller and smaller. In the discrete setting, we can't just make the terms get closer and closer and closer because there's this gap of 1 that sits between all the terms. And so because of that, this series, we really don't want to think of it as integrals. These are discrete integrals. And that's why we study series in Calculus 2. Calculus 2 is all about integration, and series are just a different type of integral from the continuous integrals we spent the previous part of our course studying here. And so what we're going to see here is that one can represent a continuous function using a discrete integral, and there's going to be a lot of power when one makes that observation.